SQL Server interview questions and answers which were asked in a recent interview in one of the MNC companies. Hi, I'm M. Asif Hussain from KnowHow Academy, where tech powers transformations. What are you going to learn from this video? You are going to see what are the different types of questions that have been asked in an interview recently from one of the MNC companies, how to solve those questions using a table or using an SQL Server. Here, wherever we go, if you are attending an interview as a Power BI developer, if you are attending an interview as a .NET developer, if you are attending an interview as a data analyst, if you are attending an interview as a business analyst, the questions from SQL Server are mandatory. Okay, we need to have a knowledge on SQL Server. If we have a knowledge on SQL Server, it will be easy for us in order to become a Power BI developer, .NET developer, data analyst, business analyst, whatever we are expecting to be. We all know that the jobs in the market are in demand with these roles as a data analyst, as a business analyst, as a Power BI developer, or as a data scientist, or so on. Wherever we go, we need to have a knowledge on SQL Server, which is a basic thing as a part of database. Now, let us see what are the questions that have been asked in an interview and how to answer those questions using SQL Server. So I'm walking you here. The first question is, they have asked to fetch the name, city, date of birth, and who are from the city Albany and whose date of birth is so and so. And now we need to solve this question using views of SQL Server. You might have a question. Without using views also, we might easily answer these questions, right? This type of question, we can answer it easily without using a view. But my dear viewers, always remember that the interviewer will not tell you to answer the question in a simple way. Okay? They might ask you the question in two ways. Number one, an interview question can be asked with just a question and they will leave to the candidate to answer it in his or her own way. The second way is, they specifically mention that you need to use views or you need to use a stored procedure or you need to use a trigger to solve this. Okay, so it purely depends upon the interviewer. Okay, if the interviewer is leaving up to the candidate to solve this type of question, I will just write the select statement and leave. I don't go with the views. But here, they specifically mentioned that we need to use views. So for that, let me first retrieve the customer table. So they might have asked me the, you know, in the interview, they might have asked the employee table, the student table, or any other table. So here I'm considering the customer table in order to solve this question. Only the city name and the date of birth is changing. Rest everything is the same. Now, when I execute it, we can see that we have the columns called first name and last name of the customer. We have the gender of these customers. We have email ID, date of birth, contact numbers, address from which city they belong to, the state, zip code, and the password. Now, if you carefully observe this, the question is that we need to fetch the name, the city, the date of birth. Okay, we need to fetch the city, the names, and the date of birth of the customers who belong to the city Albany. Okay, so for this, let us not look into the view completely. First, let us see the select statement. What I'm writing, select, I want to see the customer email. Okay, they did not ask me the customer email, but okay, if they did not ask me, I will not choose it. Okay, they have asked me the customer names. Okay, I have considered my customer first name, customer last name. What did they ask? They need to see the city and the date of birth also. So I have written the city column, date of birth column from which table? From customer table. So if I execute only this select statement, I'll get everything. I'll get every single detail. But the condition is that we need to create a view to check the city Albany and the date of birth that they have mentioned. So I am writing a where condition also. So now what I am doing, I am just writing create view name. That's it. A view name can be of your choice. Probably whenever you are writing a view name, please make sure that you write VW at the starting so that it can indicate that this is a view name. Okay. So I am creating a view with a view name. Then I am writing a select statement where city equal to Albany. Now what happens? So whenever the client or whenever the customer or whenever the interviewer wants to see to see the people who belongs to the city Albany and who have the date of birth so and so, then directly if he executes a view name, we can get the result. Whenever they want to see, they can just use the view name and they can see the people who belong to the city Albany and the date of birth. So this is the way of answering the first question. I'm repeating the question again. The question is, my interviewer wants to fetch the name, city and date of birth columns who belongs to the city Albany and the date of birth so and so. So whenever this question is asked, we can directly write the select statement with the where clause. But as they have specifically mentioned that we need to use views, I have used view here. Okay. So this is a solution for the first question. Let me walk you through the next question. The next question is that they are asking us to create a stored procedure. Okay, very important topic, stored procedure. Now, in this stored procedure, what they are expecting? They want to create a stored procedure in order to get the customer email, customer name, and payment amount based upon the customer email and pay amount. Okay, the condition they have kept is the pay amount should be less than the minimum pay amount. Okay, please be very careful to understand this kind of questions. This question is very easy, little bit tricky. Okay, so if you read the question more than one time, the answer is very easy. All right, so I am repeating the question again. My interviewer has asked me a question that create a stored procedure to fetch information. What information? Customer email, customer name, and payment amount based upon the customer email. Now the point is that they want to see the payment amount which should be less than the maximum pay amount. Okay, so for this, how should we create a stored procedure? So the payment details are not there in the customer table. Am I right? We don't have payment details. So for this, what I'm doing, I'm taking the payment detail table here. So from this payment detail table, we can see that, okay, so we can see that we have payment detail ID, we have payment mode, what is the payment date and how much did they pay for it. Okay, so we have all these details in the payment detail table. Now the condition is that if you carefully observe, as we do not have the payment details in the customer table, we need to use another table called payment detail. Now when we want to fetch the information from the customer table and the payment detail table, we have to join these two tables, then we need to get the solution out of it. Okay, so for this, what I am trying to do, I am creating a stored procedure. That's what my question is. So I am creating a procedure with a procedure name as, now I am writing a select statement. In this select statement, if you see, I am choosing the customer email, customer first name, customer last name, and my customer and the payment amount, okay, from table customer, and I'm naming the customer as C table. That's why I'm writing the alias C here. Okay, so I'm joining with which table? With the payment detail table. The what is the common column between the customer table and the payment detail table? The common column is customer email, which is the primary condition of creating a join. In order to create a join between two tables, the condition is that we need to have the common column, at least one common column. So customer email is a common column. So what I'm doing here, I'm joining these two with the common column customer email. Now I'm using a subquery here to answer this question. So what's happening here? If you say this, what I'm doing here, I am using where payment amount. What is the question? Payment amount should be less than maximum payment amount. So I'm using less than. I'm writing a subquery under select statement. I'm writing first, I'm fetching out what is my maximum pay amount. So if I show you, the maximum pay amount that we have is 202.95. So less than the maximum pay amount, that should be our answer. Okay. So I'm ordering it with the, in a descending order, I'm ordering my payment amounts. Okay. As a descending order, bigger value to the smaller value. So let me repeat the solution again. I am creating a procedure with a procedure name as, and now I am writing a select statement using a join because I need to have two tables in it. and I'm writing a subquery with a maximum pay amount and I'm ordering it in a descending order. Okay. So if I execute this one, commands completed successfully. Okay. So what is the, if I want to execute the solution for it, so what I am writing, select so in order to see the result out of it, what I am doing, I am executing my stored procedure name, which is select customers. When I have executed it, if you carefully observe, we have got customer email, customer first name, customer last name, and the payment amount. And what is the condition? Less than the maximum pay amount. So what is the maximum pay amount? It was 202. Now less than 202, whatever are the values, all those values we got it in the output. So it is very simple. We need to just understand the question in a very easy way to solve this type of questions. All right. So this is how you need to solve a question when it is being asked with a stored procedure. Now let me walk you through the next question, which is the very important question, and this question will be asked in every interview you go, though you are an experienced person, though you are a fresher, this question is for sure. How to fetch the duplicate records from a table? It might be employee table, student table, product table, customer table, it can be any table. Okay, so I am fetching the duplicate records from a customer table. They have asked me to fetch the duplicate records from a customer table. So now what I am doing here, first let me show you the customer table. So we have multiple customer names which are repeated. If you see Anthony, Anthony, which are repeated two times. Okay. So if you see here, there are many names which are repeated two times. So let us see the duplicate record. So I would like to see what is the condition. The condition they have given me is they need to fetch the duplicate records by considering the first name column. So what I'm doing here, let me see how many names are repeated how many times. So for this, what I'm going to do, I am selecting count, I'm writing a select statement, I'm writing count because I'm counting how many times the name is repeated. Okay. So the first name from which table? From customer table. So whenever we need to fetch the duplicate records, always remember group by and having is must. So I'm grouping all the customer names into one. For example, Asif name is repeated five times. So all these five names will be grouped into one, and it will show that Asif repeated five times. Okay. It will not show you the individual time. Asif. No, Asif name is repeated five times. All Asif names will be clubbed into one. It will show that Asif name is repeated for five times. Okay. So now I'm counting the complete names and I want to show in the output whichever name is repeated more than one time. So whenever any value or any name, it is repeated more than one time, it means that it is a duplicate. Am I right? So let us see the value or answer from this particular query. We can see that all these names are repeated more than one time. See, Anthony is repeated for two times. Okay. Chad is repeated for two times. So these are the names. There are 13 names which are repeated more than one time, which are having the duplicate names. All right. So this is how you can fetch the duplicate records from a table. Always remember, fetching out the duplicate records from a table is a mandatory question if you are attending an interview. Please do not forget to learn this question, practice it multiple times so that you can be easily selected in any interview. Okay. So I'm walking you through the next question, which is deleting the duplicate records. Now I have shown you how to fetch the duplicate records. Now I'm going to show you how to delete the duplicate records. They might not ask for fresher candidates, but they might ask for experienced candidates. Okay. So though you are 1 year experience, though you are 2 year experience, though you are 3 years of experience, deleting duplicate records is the question most probably will be asked for experienced people, not for the freshers. If your interviewer is very senior, okay, if you are also very much talented by answering all the questions in one go when the interviewer is asking you the questions, then yes, there might be the probability that you might also face this question, deleting the duplicate records. Okay, so now let us see how to delete the duplicate records. It is very easy. We can delete the duplicate records with the common table expression. Okay, so what I'm doing here, I am writing with statement. Whenever you start the query with the with, it is indicating that it is a common table expression. So I am writing with what a common table expression, with a common table expression, any name you can choose it of your choice. So as I'm opening up the bracket, I'm writing the select statement. I want to fetch every column from a table. So row number, it will assign the row numbers for each of the hierarchy that we have given. Row number over what? I'm partitioning it with the hospital. So for example, If I would like to show you the table first, let me show you the table first. Then it is easy for you to understand. Select the star from doctors. So I want to fetch the doctors table. Select the star from doctors. When I fetch this table, we can see that there are multiple hospitals which are repeated. Okay. If we see here, okay, Yashoda Hospital is one time, Ames is two times, Fernandez Hospital is two times, and Apollo Hospital is one time, right? So I want to delete the duplicate records. So duplicate records are for Ames Hospital and for Fernandez Hospital, right? So now I want to delete these duplicate records by I'm partitioning it by the hospital and I'm ordering it. You know, when I talk about an order, it will become in a alphabetical order. So though if you're not giving the word specifically as descending, it will not consider it as a descending. Okay. If you are not giving any order, by default, it is ascending. All right. So now what I'm doing here, I'm writing this particular thing with the name as a row number from doctor's table. So now let me fetch you this particular query and I'll show it to you. We can see that, see, Ames Hospital is one. Okay. Ames Hospital is again two. Again, a new hospital has come. It is one. Okay. Fernandez is one. And Fernandez, again, it is repeated. That's why it is two. Again, Max Vision Hospital is one and cardiology is one. Okay, sorry. Yashoda Hospital is repeated only once. So this one, Fernandez Hospital is two times and Ames Hospital is two times. So whichever is more than one time, that will be removed from this particular table. Okay, so I'm writing a with as a common table expression. I'm writing a select statement and I'm deleting it. From which particular common table expression, that common table expression name that we have given it here, where row number is greater than one. When you use this row number, it will be easy for you to delete the duplicate records. For example, whichever row number is more than one, that will be removed. So two is here, right? That will be removed. Okay. So if I execute it, two rows affected. See this? Two rows affected. So let me show you the doctor's table. We can see that, okay, Ames Hospital is only one time now and Fernandez Hospital is also one time now. Earlier it was two times, right? So this is how you can delete the duplicate records from a table in SQL Server. So this question might be asked for you. If you are an experienced person, please make sure to practice this kind of questions. There might be many ways in order to delete the duplicate records, but using a common table expression with a row number will probably help you in order to solve this question in a very easy way. That's where I have preferred to answer this question using common table expression. So these are the few questions that have been asked in a recent interview for 2 to 3 years of experienced guy in one of the MNC's companies. That's where I have taken those questions and answered it for you. Please make sure to practice these questions and try to answer these questions in different ways to make sure that you are perfect before going to any interview of SQL Server. So thank you for choosing KnowHow Academy as your source for IT knowledge. We are always here to help you to navigate the tech world. If you have any questions, do not hesitate to reach out. It's been a pleasure sharing this information with you. Stay curious and keep learning.